Hey guys, we're gonna do some Kerbaling tonight. Been a while since I've done anything with Kerbal. I'm contemplating whether I want to resume save, whether I want to start new. I think maybe we should resume save just to see exactly where we left off, because I don't remember. I seem to think that we were trying to venture out into the outer realm of the solar system there. What about Bob? That's where we were. Year 140, day 293. Wow. Yeah. 140 years. Of course, 1 year on Kerbal is like, I think, 3 or 4 months on real life, because their days are like only 6 hours long. Or something like that. I seem to think that's what it was. I can't remember. Let's see if it even loads. It's been a long time since I've been in the save, so I don't even know if it's going to load. Oh, we've got something. We've got something. Okay, let's see where we're at here. There's our space center. Let's go to our tracking station here. See what we had out there. I did update this, right? Yeah. Pretty certain I updated it. I don't remember. That's right, we were trying to push out here towards Neldon. Big deep research. Days for deep calm. We had things. It still had some maneuver nodes, didn't we? Chad, I think some of these guys here were getting ready to maneuver. Which means we should have those on the alarm clock down here. Yes. Dogs are barking for some reason. Didn't mean to stop it that quick. Four days. Let's switch to that one. Got real quiet. Oh yeah, these guys. Was this hibernating? Place maneuver nodes. There's already a node on this flight path. We have to aim towards our maneuver. Come in here. Execute next node. Time warp. Slowing down, slowing down, slowing down. I forgot what I had on this thing. I think I had a nuke. Yep. Five kilowatts. If we point it normal, there we go. That should be pointing back towards Kerbal. Why is this not rotating? Oh. Because I think our reaction control wheels are... I seem to think I turned them all off. Oh, they are running. So why can't I rotate this thing? I know the keyboard works. Reset all sciences. I don't think there's any science on here for this thing to reset. I'm playing a little bit of Kerbal tonight. We just been away for a little too long, so We decided to spice things up a bit. But I can't, for some reason, figure out why I have no rotational control on this thing. It's like my keys are all swapped around here. She joins me on stream oft. I don't understand. Are you saying when is she going to pick up a Twitch channel? Is that what you're asking? Apply, accept. It's just in the settings menu. Oh, when am I gonna get her to play Kerbal? Oh, that may take some time because she's. My daughter's in there freaking out over D&D. She's on her D&D group. I just heard her scream like something bad happened, and I think it did. I think she just lost her character. She doesn't go for all the science-y stuff. Okay. Why are none of my controls working here? I don't understand why... Because I should at least have... See, it moves here, but why does it not respond to my keyboard command? I don't even have thrust here. Do I need to turn Kerbal alarm clock off? Is that what's hanging this whole thing up here? command. Oh, it's in hibernation. That's probably why. Now let's see if it works. Ah, there it goes. So why was it making the maneuvers before if that thing was in hibernation? This game sometimes. There. Is that thing drawing or is it still climbing? Got those numbers so small I can't see them. It looks like it's climbing. Yeah. Okay. We could probably shut this motor down now. And if we come in here, we look at this bad boy here. Electric charge is climbing. Deactivate reactor, transfer waste. It's almost forever, so this thing's hardly even depleted any fuel yet. It's got years worth of life out here. All right, let's go to the Space Center. Let's plug this thing in. Do I even have any skill points that I can spend? No. Everything at this point is just gravy. What about hiring of Kerbals? Look, more engineers and scientists. We could use more scientists. And look, another scientist. Pilot. We got tons of pilots. Dun, 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 dun. Lost, zero missing. Yeah, these poor guys. What a bad situation that was. So I found something interesting. This was an old voice recorder that I had a long time ago. It had some real interesting voice recordings on it. Alright, when's our next one due? 129 days. That's gonna take a while. Down to 100 days. What's up with Big Com? Things are slowing down because that thing is due for its time warp. Fly like an eagle. Thank you. There's no cone on this one. Interesting. Point towards its maneuver node. Command, take it out of hibernation. Fire up Jeb. Execute next maneuver. And we need to come in here. Open all the radiators. I don't know if I activated the radiators on the other one. All right, that one's ready. And it is charging, yes. Excuse me. What are you doing, big girl? Huh? What are you doing, big girl? Who's a big girl? I got a bulldog down here. She's looking at me like she wants to go to bed already. Yes. Looking at me like you want to go to bed already. I know it's 8 o'clock and it's dark outside and you can't rationalize it. Wait another 3 months and then it'll be light outside, okay? Let's go back to BigCom 3. And make sure, I don't think I turned those radiators on. I don't understand what that meant, but it really kind of sounded pretty cool. Oh, all the radiators are on. Okay, they're all on. It's not pointed towards the star anymore. That's okay. I guess it doesn't matter what direction it's pointing. Know what I always find really interesting about this game? Is it really looks like this thing's just sitting here, not moving. But that's the thing about space, is it's so vast and open that you really don't... Unless something's coming towards you, you can't tell whether or not you're moving. You just look static. And I really like the effect that they got here. That you're not moving. That's how massive space is. It's just incomprehensible. That's one of the effects that I like most about this. Just that starts there, and you're just hanging. Just hanging there. Of course, there's a lot more light in this game than there is actually out there. A lot of these panels here would be completely dark. In fact, let's go in and I've got to turn that music down just a little bit because it's still a little loud. Apply. Let's see if there's some lighting textures here. Ambient light boost. Well, let's see what that does. Yeah, that's more... That's more of what it would actually look like. That is more realistic lighting. Because these are kind of see-through, so you would still get some light bleeding through. What would happen if we turn the ambient light boost down all the way? Make it more realistic. Accept. Yeah, I think that's a little more accurate. How dark everything is. That's definitely more what it would be like this far out. Because we are really, really far out. And you'd just barely be getting a little bit of bleed off of some of the light passing through there. But for the majority of it, it would be just dark. Especially when you're using dark material. But we like to turn things up in the game so we can see what's going on. Especially when things come flying apart. Now, I'm really concerned because we've got... Ooh. Yeah, I think I remember why I had it turned up. That's exactly why I had it turned up, so I could actually see the Space Center. Let's put it right back at 0. That's a little too bright. That doesn't look nighttime-ish. I guess if there were no moon, ambient light boost editor, huh? Yeah, I'd say that's probably a little more realistic. I, I'm surprised they don't have as many lights on the space center as they would in real life. I mean, those things are lit up pretty bright. As seen from space. So a friend of mine was selling his truck, and in the ad he had all these pictures of his truck, and then he just had a picture of the Earth, and underneath it it says, "This is what my truck looks like from space." I thought it was pretty funny. Humor's lost on a lot of people, but it wasn't lost on me. I enjoyed it. I chuckled. Come on, DeepCom 5, where are you? I don't know why it's like locked in up there, but something happened. 6 days. Fly! That one's just a little out of orbit. Because I didn't plan it right. It's too close to DeepCom 2, I think. Fly like an eagle. Come on. And this is running on SSD, and it's still running this slow. It's all the mods! Alright. I'm gonna turn in. Kick all you guys on. Come inside here. We're gonna kick you on. Get our reactor fired up. We're going to come in here, turn your hibernation off, wake it up, and execute your maneuver node. One day to the maneuver. One minute to the maneuver. Close and delete. If you just saw my camera move, that was not an earthquake. That was a bulldog. She just jumped up on her chair. She could snooze a bit. And the chair sits right up against my desk, so when she jumps up there, it bumps the desk back and forth. Causes everything to shake. Got my camera fixed, by the way. Last few times, it's kind of been a little wonky, so. Now we can set it and aim it towards the sun. Whoosh. Because that way it's communicating to Kerbal. Go ahead and shut this engine down. Just so we don't have any weird mishaps. Alright, that's in position. I don't remember. Did we ever get any of the science from the Arctic? Don't recall. Wondering if we should build a little cruiser to... Alright, let's check in on our other vessels here, because I think we've got some vessels floating around that need a little bit of help here. Alright, let's go check out Super Spy, Dark Web. I think we want deep research landed at Moho. Gotta see what this is. I do not remember what this craft is. I don't remember if this is one that we crashed or one that we landed to collect science. I don't remember which one this is. But they've been there for a while. If it's got Kerbals on it, they've been there for a while. And if that's the case, we might need to bring some people home. But I think we might need to mount a rescue mission to do it, because if it's... It's been so long since I've played, I don't remember what this craft is. So I'm not 100% sure what... There's definitely Kerbals on there. It is wibbly wobbly. We got two Kerbals here, and those things are hot. We're using massive monopropellant. Shut that off. I think we could probably... We're running science. It's pretty dark. Are we on the dark side of Moho? That would be pretty cool. Don't think I've ever taken off from the dark side of Moho. I don't remember where we're at here. We are definitely on the dark side of Moho. So, I don't know what direction we're pointed here when I come into this view. Let's see. That's going to be north. So, we'll want to take off and... Let's go north. We want to go this way. need my orbital info. So I have no idea how high I am. 100. Yeah, a little bit more. It's still a little low. Maneuver, boost, 51, 54, 53, 54. All right, point towards that, and execute next node. We are now in orbit around Moho. Mohoho. Data. Science. Start research. We could probably turn those lights off now. I forgot about this weird little thing here. Fusion tank. I can't remember. Is this running? It looks like it's running. Power generator, 400 kilowatts. I don't think I need that much kilowatts on this thing, do I? I don't think there's a way to actually adjust how much output this thing has on it. Where is it storing all of that data? I think it's storing it all here in it. Keep that experiment. See if there's anything we can transmit. Oh, just passed it. Because I seem to think we've got the majority of this already in... in science. Yeah, see, there's no data on that, so that's junk. That's junk. That's junk. Oh, why is it all junk now? Transmit that. All right, let's see if we can plan a return. Transmit that. Yeah, I think I remember why I was transmitting all the science on this thing somewhere else. Okay. Mecha Jeb. We want our maneuver planner. Transfer to another planet. Advanced transfer. Must select planet. Oh, I'll select a planet, all right. How long are these guys? These guys have been on this mission for 4 years. Set as target. 47 days. Create node. Include capture burn. Create node. Now it's going to think about it for 2.5 years. Might even crash the game. We shall see. Yay, it survived. And now we're going to add this to the Kerbal alarm clock. Add. Oh. Add alarm. Where's the other one? They're both there. Okay. Yeah, 26 years. Eep. That's that's really going out there. Hey, we're getting sunlight. Hopefully these things will start to cool. How much time do they have? I seem to remember that if I ever time warp this thing, it either bursts into flames and dies, or if I exit out and time warp and come back, this thing doesn't log any science. Because this module here is kind of a wonky module that's all screwed up. That should allow the solar winds to blow across there and cool those things off more. All right, back to Space Center. We'll probably come back and that thing will burst into flames. Usually what ends up happening.
It did the job once before.
Go check on our other craft that's heading into deep, 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 deep space. It's really going out there. It's still technically in the inner solar system. Hasn't gotten to the outer solar system yet. Which tells you how long it's going to take. It says it's going to take 26 years. I don't think those guys won't be there for 26 years. But either way, they're just about... I guess they're in the outer solar system now, because that's all inner. This is all outer. And this is our point that we're heading to. But let's check in on these fellers. They're supposed to be real fart smellers. We're gonna see how fart they are. Sometime this week. Come on. Hey, Ladybird. How you doing, baby? Huh? How you doing? Alright, let's see what these real fart smellers are up to. Oh, that's right. These guys were doing solar that way, weren't they? And that looks like it's going down. Transmit science. They're full up. I'm fairly confident that this thing has a nuclear generator on it. It doesn't, because we don't have... Alright. I don't think these guys are coming home. I think this is a one-way mission for them. That's kind of sad. Had any more science. Could take all that Moho science and transfer it up here. Well, these guys gotta be turned towards the sun. That's why they're not getting any power. Gonna get to the point of diminishing returns. I wonder if we turn this off and just started rotating this thing like this, if energy wise. It's not really helping, is it? In fact, it was actually making it worse. See, this is a problem with solar. These guys are coming home. At least we've got stored charge for them. Okay. So we know things are going to be a while. Maybe we should build a little cruiser to go explore some land masses. Wonder if we could make... multi-purpose vessel that not only does good on the ground, but also does good in the water. I seem to think we were playing around with probes the last time. Let's see what we had in the old box here. Kerbin Exploder 23. That's definitely an Exploder, isn't it? I seem to think this thing was pretty stable. I just don't know how well it did in the water. Come on, load up. I know you wanna. My hard drive is going like crazy over here. All right, turn on the lights. Let's look at our energy here. Hitting the brakes. We want to speed it up. Seem to think this thing gets going pretty quick. We only have one drive wheel. Yeah, no, it actually is very stable for what it does. You just can't make any like high speed turns. But for the most part, it's very stable. I just want to see how well it does when it hits the water. Am I heading towards water? I'm pretty sure I am. Just taking the long way. That's okay. I don't know why I'm always doing this stuff at night, though. Oh, yeah, that's the other thing. I gotta be real gentle on the brakes, because if I hit the brakes too hard, this thing will want to tip over. I think I've only got one wheel driving this thing, though. Motor is disabled, yeah. Motor disabled. Enabled, so that means this one over here is enabled, right? Yep. So I've got two wheels driving it. I don't know. It's not really her cup of tea. She's not really too sciencey on this kind of stuff. But we're working on some things. She, I'll see what we can do. So, she's more into the dinosaur stuff. She watches me play Kerbal, and she has said many times she doesn't understand how I can understand this stuff. But I grew up being a space case, so when it came to space, I was always usually on top of it. My wife never grew up being a space case. She likes Star Trek and stuff, but when it came to things that are in the sky, she just, that wasn't something she always looked at. Okay, I'm gonna probably get this thing in the water and it's gonna stop dead in its tracks and not move. Well, and oops, I wasn't paying attention and hit the water a little fast. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. We are floating in the water. I wonder if I can get her to spin this thing over. Leave seat. No, well, it moves in the water, okay. I have to be on it. Kerbal's not too big. Yeah, I actually finished the original series of Star Trek. This last week. It had been a long time since I'd watched it. Alright, let's see if we can push, push. Come on, flip over, flip over. Come on, come on. I know you wanna. I know you wanna. Come on. I know you want it. You're getting there. Almost there. Come on. I should. Come on, keep pushing it. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. It's beached. Climb. She wrecked it. Recover vessel. We'll have to go get another one. See if we can tow this one out. What do you want? What do you want to move? What do you want to boot? She's gonna start yapping at me, telling me it's time to go up and go to bed, huh? Yeah. Who just whoop-whooped me? Yeah, hi, Polly. Do you want to come say hi to all your internet friends? Do you want to come say hi to all your internet friends? Come on. Come say hi to everybody. Come on. I know, you're just looking at me like you want to go to sleep. I get it. Come on. Come on. No, she doesn't want to come up. She doesn't want to say hi to you guys. I just want to see how well this thing paddles through the water. That's all I want to see. That's it. I know. What? I know. I gotta wake up early tomorrow, huh? Alright. Let's launch this again. And this time, we'll be just as gentle and careful as we were the first time. Which means we're not. We're just gonna run it straight down the runway, jump it right off the end. Hey, she has every right to lay there. You weren't using it. You weren't using it. Don't even growl at her. You go lay down in her bed. Or lay down on your chair. But don't growl at her because she's in your bed. Okay? You know, I probably should have adjusted the lights a little bit because those lights were a little too close together. All right, brakes are off. Thing gets up to a whopping 25 meters a second. Well, sorry, 22 meters a second. That's so small, I'm having a hard time reading it. But that's its maximum surface speed is 22 meters a second. Come on, I'm almost there. Don't we have? I like how angry this thing looks at the back. This thing can't hold a straight line to save its life. All of my stuff seems to just lean to the left, and I don't know why. Probably because I have more weight on that side, so it's... Yeah, I need those lights to... shoot down the road a little more. We were airborne there for a second. Starting to get down towards the water. I need to slow this thing down. So we don't hit it going 22 meters a second like we did last time. Roll this thing over. We want to slide in at a gentle gentle 4 meters a second. Nice gentle 4 meters a second. Just slide it right in there. Lean it back. Lean it back. Come on. No! Alright. It clearly is top heavy, and it's getting into the water, and the nose is just pitching down. Yeah, it's nose heavy. Because that time I went in, and it just kept tipping forward. So we're going to have to redesign something else that's not so nose heavy. But still has all the fabulous science. Maybe what we could do is put like a skid plate or something on the front of it. I don't know. Let's see what we can do. Yeah. I'm tired. It's been a long day for me. I've already I've already bored one viewer. Alright, let's see here. What do we have that structure-wise that we could use as like a good platform? Oh, that says ATV frame. That's a motorcycle frame. How big is that? That's way too heavy. How big is this feller? Man, that thing's tiny. Look at that little fella. That might work. I think I need to do a little bit of design work here. Let's go here. And we need to turn that off. like all those pipes are welded together. Slide that back just a little bit. Yeah, I like it. I don't know what I'm going to do about it yet, but I like it. That looks like that needs to rotate just a smidge, doesn't it? Ah! We'll see how it looks. Alright. Structural panel. Transparent aluminum? It's definitely transparent. And it is definitely aluminum. I really have no idea where I'm going with this, guys. I am just... I am just seeing what I can slap together here. That's a 1 meter by 1 meter. This is a 2 meter, yeah. That needs to come up just a smidge more. The problem with transparent aluminum is that it's transparent. Okay. Thank you. Well, that didn't come together well, did it? Oh, those things are huge. My gosh, how big of a critter do they think I'm building here? Oh, those barely touch the ground, don't they? Probably because I got them installed wrong. This is going to be more of a trike than it is a motorcycle. Single. Snap. Alright, let's see how that looks. Trike nut. Yeah, that's fine. Launch anyway. I just want to see how it looks on the ground. See if I'm going to have any clearance issues. It's gonna have one fantastic rake on it. So we might need to relocate that wheel there. Otherwise, it seems to be working okay. This thing just doesn't look like it's turning, though. I can't recover this vessel. I've got to wait for it to stop or crash or something because I can't recover it. I don't have any control unit on it. Well, that was a big oopsie. This thing could roll for months now. recover it. That did not go as planned. Maybe that wheel's non-animated, so it just doesn't, you don't see it turn. You know, sometimes they get parts like that that are non-animated. So you just have to use your imagination from the day. I should have just reverted back to space plane hangar. I don't know why I went through all this. Says it's powered. I don't know, it almost looked cooler being out in front, I think. Let's see here. Let's put one of these seats on it here. But we need to, yeah, I know, go away. Oh my gosh, okay. I'm just trying to move it back. This is how you know the DPI on your mouse is not very good. There. When you've got to make precision movements like that, you know your DPI in your mouse is not good. Okay. We need batteries. Lots and lots of batteries. Because we need some sort of power source. Electrical. Where's our little isotope generator? Go. They're sitting on top of a nuclear bomb. Alright, let's put some lighting. We need lights. Lights. That's still under electrical. No. I have totally forgotten where the lights were. gotta be here under utility. There's our light right there, illuminator. Let's give this a try. Has no remote controlled or manned command modules. It absolutely does. What's this? External command seat. Yeah. Oh, I haven't assigned a crew to it. That's why. There, now it should launch. That's why. I just hadn't assigned any kind of intelligence to it. I got a bad feeling this thing's going to be super fast and it's going to flip right over. It's got a massive power source on this thing. How do we not have... How do we not have any power? Because the generator has nothing to go into. Okay. And it's like super tail heavy. Recover vessel. Why didn't I just go back and... I gotta remember to go... revert back to vehicle assembly building instead of recover. I don't know why I keep doing that. Evidence would suggest I'm a total and complete idiot. How much would it cost me for you to come help me get this water pump done? It's rusted badly. Got a friend who's doing a water pump on a, it's like a Dodge van, and he can't get the water pump off because there's a rusted bolt. A rusted bolt on a car? No, say it ain't true. Eh, that never happens. There's cars are never rusted. Good news is, how heavy was that isotope generator? One, 4 tons. And the seat was how much? 3.05. So if we put some battery packs, which why I didn't put those on there to start with, I don't know. Those are too big. I don't think we have anything heavy enough. I guess we could add some lead weights to the front of this. Those are super small. God, those things are tiny. How did I ever get anything done on this? Structure. Oh, that didn't attach to anything, did it? There, I should counterbalance it a little bit. Let's see how this goes. How this does now. It's gonna come in butt down. Because that's how I left it. I need to have it like this. So clearly it's gonna start like this. Because, as I said, I'm a total and complete moron. At least I have 200 electrical charge on it now. The isotope generator should produce enough power to drive these wheels. At least we have power now. Revert flight. Revert to vehicle assembly plant. Or space hangar. Whatever we're calling it. Revert back to the hangar. We're going to get this little motorcycle to work, and then we're going to put little things of science on this thing. try this again. Let's see if it falls flat on its face again. Well, I think I need to raise that little steering wheel up a bit. Light-wise, it looks pretty good. Wow, that's bouncy. I think we need to go with a different wheel altogether. He's gonna roll it! He's gonna roll it! You just rolled your motorcycle. Remove helmet. Good thing he was wearing his helmet. I don't know what exploded. We lost something here. Hey. I just gotta get that thing down on that one wheel. I think we lost battery. That's what exploded. Alright, we gotta find a different wheel on this. Revert flight. Space plane hangar. That wheel was just too... Yes, I'll do it again. That wheel is garbage. It's not designed for high speeds. What wheel do we have? How big is this guy? Oh, that thing's huge. Can we make it smaller? Can we reduce the size of this part? I don't see anything here that is tweak scale. Yeah, that's not gonna work. That's what about the Rove Max? That's not much better. I don't know. Maybe it is. G- give it a little bit of a rake. That's turnable. That's steerable, right? Steering direction, yeah. Let's try it. What could possibly go wrong? It's definitely got to be a better wheel than the other one. The other one was just... It was just bad. It had no real steering control. Not this thing's going to have very good steering control either. I mean, it's a trike. It's designed for speed. Well, it actually looks more stable. The wheel seems to work good. Bumps in this bumpy runway. Whoa, what just exploded? What did we just... We just lost our wheel for some reason. I don't understand how we lost our wheel. Okay, then. It was stable, at least. Revert back to vehicle. We're coming up on the two-hour mark, guys. We're at 1 hour and 54 minutes. All right. You, my fine feathered friend. I think we need... Oh, you're already auto-strutted. Rigid attachments. Let's slide that thing back just a smidge. And let's... All this stuff is set up rigid attachment, right? Auto strut, heaviest part. I guess the wheels are automatically set up for that because this was auto strut. Rigid attachment. I'm gonna make this guy here solid too. Ejection force. All of it. Yeah, kind of. It's a trike bike. With an isotope generator. Haven't put any science on it yet, but we're just testing out to see how stable it is. Yeah. So far, we've lost several wheels. The front wheels, for some reason, don't want to cooperate with us because there's really no good selection of steering wheels in this game. You can't find one that works well. And I may just have to go with two wheels on the front and put some poles and stuff out. No, actually, I solved the tail heavy issue because I put a lead weight on the front, so it's now more nose heavy than it is tail heavy. But I think all in all, it balanced the weight out. I'll have to look at it again. But I just think I'm over revving this little wheel here. So we're gonna enable this. It looks like that thing's... Wait a minute, shouldn't this thing... Why does that not look like it's extended like it was? Things really moving. Ah, see? That wheel just gave up. Revert back. Got to look at something because something didn't look right. Yeah, see, it's more... It's more extended here than it is. Let's see if that works better. Because it just looked all compressed when... So I'm wondering if it just didn't have any bounce and it was taking abuse. Come on, load up. Yeah, see how collapsed that spring is now? Let's see if it runs better now. Because now it looks like it's actually bouncing. Usually I just click and say, like, EVA. I don't know of the exact hotkey. is what I meant by telling you about. I just don't think we had any spring in our step before. Ooh, hey, well, it turns real well now. Almost too well. That's why you wear a helmet, kids. Well, it held together this time, but it, see if we can get it to flip over. Board. That seat is obstructed. All right, revert flight to launch. It like turned and then it wouldn't turn again. It just kept veering off. Doing donuts. Revert flight. All right. We need a little bit more stability, I think. Structure right there, and we want to go, where's our small I-beam? Whoa! I think it's huge. I just am looking for a simple I-beam. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. It was crooked. What the heck, man? I guess that's as centered as it's gonna be, right? That doesn't look centered, though. Does that look centered to everybody else, or is it just me? Looks like there's more on this side than there is this side. There is, yeah, because I'm seeing more tire here than I am here. Here, why don't we do snap direction? That might help. That's better. No, that still looks crooked. It looks like there's more on this side than there is on this side. Yeah, there's... I can't tell. I need precision engineering on this thing. I mean, that right there should be center. It's going to have quite a pitch on it. What if we reduce the scale? Well, now they hardly look it. I think 75 might be a little better. Bring that in a little more, bring these up just a bit. Bring those in just a little more to make them look like they were actually welded on there. That looks better. Still a little high. Right about there. Let's try that. Let's see if that makes it a little more stable. And let's see if it makes it more, less bouncy and keeps a straight line. Technically, it's no longer a trike because we got four wheels on it. We may have to rename it. And if these wheels don't work, then I think I'm going to go with some of the smaller rover wheels. Put those on there. We still haven't put any science on this thing, but... yeah, that thing's still raked up pretty high. Look at the angle on that. Those things bounce. Taking up a lot of vibration. Suspension work on those things. This is a rough runway. I'm surprised how rough this runway is. Alright. They held up a little better, but I still don't like how... Maybe I should reduce the shock on them a bit. Set those for, because now we've got a second one on there, but they're both probably about the same load rating as the first one when it was single. Let's see here. We could also raise this thing here up a bit because it is sitting slightly low. Bring it up to about right here. That's a little better. That should take a lot of the rake out of it. A reverse rake. Makes it look like a North Carolina truck. Jerks. Let's set this for auto. And let's go ahead and disable the motors on these things. Disabled, disabled, because we've got these guys here driving it. That way we take away part of the drive for it, so it's just being pushed by the rear wheels. Oh yeah, that's a little better. Well, we spun out. This thing's all over the place. Seemed like I had a little bit better control with the non-bouncy when the wheels were more. All right, stop. See if we can make some infield adjustments here. are spinning again, but we don't seem to be rolling as much as we were. What if we give this thing more traction? Flying again. Revert to space here. I think we're gonna have to go with some different wheels. I don't think these wheels are gonna do it. We're not stable enough. Gives me a little bit wider footprint, doesn't it? We can no longer call it Trike Nut. We're going to have to call it Quad Pod. There. I think these wheels might be better. Give us a little more stance. I think they absorb shock better, so we should be able to hold a straight line. Oh, did I turn the motors off on them? I don't think I did. That's okay. What could possibly go wrong? I may have to move those wheels back here down a bit, because that's a pretty radical rake on the front of that thing. Okay. Drive motors disabled. On both. Nope, that motor's enabled. Disable that one. Well, yeah, because those weren't symmetric, were they? Alright, turn the lights on. Well, that's a pretty neat feature. I'm curious now. I don't think we'll have any steering control with that. Yeah, those are just gonna drag. Look at how much it bounces, though. It's probably just a runway. This isn't the smoothest runway in the game. We're up to 30 meters a second. That's pretty awesome. Oh, keep it straight. Keep her straight. Ooh, whoa! Ah! Deep! Hit the brake! need to figure out a way to flip these things over. Let's look at our center of gravity on this thing and see exactly what's going on here. Maybe we need to add a big lead weight for the front of it. I already got this big lead weight here. Center of mass. Oh, that's pretty center there. One of these things is higher than the other. And they're about the same. And this other one's just a smidgen higher. See how it performs now. Probably not going to get anywhere. I don't know why I'm screwing around with this thing. We were trying to find something that could fly in water pretty well. Now we're just building a land-based hot rod. It's going to roll over on us on a second notice. You look at it weird and it's going to go... out at all. What a bummer. Okay. Vroom, vroom. God, this thing. It spins too easy. Let's get this thing down on some dirt. Off this rough runway, because you know dirt's always so much better. Has absolutely no stability whatsoever. I get up to 17 and this thing just becomes unusable here. Stiffen that one up. Let's stiffen that one up. There. Give it a little bit more of a rough ride, but this thing gets up to 20 and it just loses All of it staring. On the plus side, we got a lot of light shining down the road there. Add a little more weight to the front of this thing. Give it a lot more downforce on the front. See, it pulls to the left. I think that's the way to water. That's the way to the monolith. I just want to see how well it travels in the water. Man, sometimes it grabs really good traction, and I mean, it should just turn a little bit when I nudge that wheel, but it's turning a lot, and I shouldn't do that. If that wheel damage is just from driving it, or if there's actual damage on those wheels. I can't remember with these. It looks like we're coming up on water. This time we're gonna just gently slide it into the water, unlike what we did last time, which was hit the water at 4 meters a second. Not slowing down, going down the hill. Why are we going downhill so fast? Stop, 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 stop. We're not stopping. It doesn't float. It's still going downhill. I find it interesting that it doesn't float. I'm actually kind of impressed that we're going uphill here, but interesting enough, we kind of made ourselves a little not, not too shabby submarine here. It's actually underwater now. I've never been this deep underwater before. I made a very interesting underwater vehicle here. I always wanted the vehicle to float on the water, but this is goes underneath it, which brings up some interesting questions here. We can travel underwater. We can travel across these oceans. And we get fairly decent speed here. And it's still going to take a while, but .35 years. We're getting awful deep in this ocean. This is an interesting craft, guys. I wasn't planning on this, but this is an interesting development. I wonder how far I can go before I fall out of the world. It is Unity. Am I traveling in the right direction? I'm trying to head over here. Meters, that's pretty good. The Samus. I find it interesting. I collected a surface sample there. Whee! It's interesting how diverse the landscaping underneath the water is on Kerbin. We're 700 meters underwater right now. Which is interesting because it looks like we're going up a hill. So we should be going upward. There we go. Now we're going up. Oh, I didn't think about that. Didn't think that I might hit a ridge so steep I won't be able to climb it. Am I heading the right way? It doesn't look like I'm even moving here. I don't know where I'm trying to go to here. That's going to be interesting. It's going to take me a long time to get there for the speed I'm traveling. Seeing as how now I've come to a complete stop. About 90 degrees, so I'm traveling almost straight. Straight east right now. So I need to travel more this way. Because there's a space center right there. It's 135. That should put us towards that island. Looks like our maximum surface speed under the water is 8 meters a second. That's going to take us a long time to reach that island at this speed and that distance. Because I think 8 meters a second comes out to be like, what, 5 or 10 or 15 miles an hour? Let's see here. Phone on my keyboard. Alright, so if we're going a whopping 8 meters a second, that comes out to be just a hair shy of 18 miles an hour. It's 2.237. One meter a second is 2.237 miles an hour. I think we're heading the wrong way. Somehow I got turned around. You know what? Let's actually head back up to here, because that's going to be a long, long trip. I'm not ready to make that trip yet. This is still a test of it, but I'm actually really impressed as to this thing's lack of buoyancy and the ability to just roll with it, Henry. Happen if we remove helmet while we're underwater? Wow, we're at 4.47 meters going up now. Or 7 meters underwater. Uh-oh, we're losing speed. Oh, gonna have to go diagonal. shall have to zigzag. So we can maintain speed. That was a pretty steep incline. We're down to 5 meters, well, 6 meters a second. Or slowly. That is a steep slope. This is probably completely boring to everybody watching it. It's exciting for me because I've never been underwater before. I know there's other people who have played Kerbal who have done it, but it's the first time for me. Alright. See if we can go ziggy zag again. I'm just going zigzag to try and maintain speed here because I'm not gaining a whole lot of speed. We're actually losing it. I gotta try and keep. Keep things running here. I can see the space center from here. I can make out a building. We're looking through it, looking at it through the ground. That's awesome. I wonder what it would look like if we were under here and the sun came out. I don't even know what time it is. That is a really big, steep ridge. Did I actually roll clear down off that thing? I mean, I must have, right? Gotta drive diagonal, 'cause that's how you climb steep grades. I think what we're seeing there is the runway. See all the little itty bitty lights there? Probably can't see those. Maybe we should turn the headlights off. Well, now we're not seeing any of those little lights. trying to climb this ridge here. Still got the motors on them. Motor enabled. Motor enabled. We're going really fast downhill. Lost all that speed. To see if we can gain it back. We're getting closer to shore. Almost 3 hours onto the stream, guys, which means it's probably close to 11 o'clock. Oh, it is 11 o'clock. Yep. I'm going to have to call it quits here pretty soon. Thing wants to go straight up that hill, and I keep trying to turn it so we're going diagonal so that we if I turn that motor off, I shouldn't dig in, should it? I almost made it worse. Banging our isotope generator pretty hard. Telling it to demand all 3 watts of that power. But we're slowly climbing. I didn't realize the shelf was this steep. That's a really steep shelf. Slowing down here. We haven't dipped below 3 meters a second though, so that's pretty good. Coming up out of it here in a minute. This is going to start drastically leveling off. At least I think it does. I don't know. Maybe this is just a sheer drop off the whole time on this. I didn't write. This is the first time I've been underwater. I don't know what it's like. As long as that meter counter keeps going up, I'm doing just fine. I don't want to lose speed here. A 100 meters underwater. That's pretty far underwater. a lot of pressure on you right now. Yeah, I think it's gonna start leveling off here. So we should start getting more speed. Yeah, we're starting to pick up speed now. It's leveled off. It's not as steep as it was. We should be able to get out of this pretty quick now. Especially if we go sideways. What if I make this thing sleek enough it would cut through the water? Watch, this whole thing blows apart a second, leaves the... Well, it's not as fast, but I was also underwater. I just left the water. Look at that. I was underwater, so it had a lot of water resistance. My maximum speed underwater was like 8 meters a second. But yeah, it's definitely not as fast as the first one. I can see the Space Center from here. That's the edge of the runway. No, that was all under... Oh! That entire journey was all underwater. Wish there was a way to just, like, flip... All right, revert flight to vehicle hangar. All right, guys, it's coming up on 3 hours of this stream, and I'm tired. I'm ready to go to bed. It's 11 o'clock. Yeah, thanks for joining. Thanks for exploring the new option of my little rover here. I think we're going to expand on this a little bit. I'm going to think about what I can do to make this thing a little bit better. I might... push these wheels out a little more to give it a little more stability, and we might look at changing some of these wheels, because while I like these wheels, they just aren't stable. So we're gonna see what we can do. I think we've got a good core. I'm kind of liking the core we've got here. So, I think we're going to keep this. We're going to expand on these wheels a bit. See what we can do. But this is the first time I've ever had a vessel that just went underwater. So, I kind of dig that idea. Because I've wanted to have an easy way to... I just got to figure out how to make it a little more... controllable underwater and a lot more speed. Because 8 meters a second... underwater, you're not going to get anywhere real fast with this thing. So, yeah. Thanks, everybody, for joining. And you all have a great night, guys. Later.